across there. There we go. Everyone, welcome back to another Seaways camping adventure. Very hot, sweaty hiking, very slippery hiking. Some of the streams aren't as bad as I thought, but I think by tomorrow they'll be miniature rivers. Anyway, I'm back in the same spot. I've done about two or three nights here with different tents. Tonight we've got a new tent. We've got the 3FUL Floating Cloud 2. Give that a good test. First things first, I'm going to get the tarp up. It'll give us our shelter. Set up the tent and our little table and chair, and I'll get back to you. There. Oh. All right. Oh man, it's hot work. Okay, I've got the same One Tiger's tarp, and I'm just going to set it up in the same way I did the last time. I just need to find our correct way up. Okay, pretty sure that is onto there, if I'm correct. So that way. Yeah. Ooh, man. Ourselves some adjustment. Oh man. Alright. I'll take the side first. Now we can go over to this corner. Okay, what do we put this to? Alright, we can get that up a bit tighter. That'll be alright. Right, now we need our upright stick. Where's he gone? Okay, I can go over here. Tie you off to this one. This one here, you can go over here. All right, everyone. That's our tarp. Just need to put my protector over the top of the stick. Very nice. Be our backup light. There we go, that may help. All right, now I have here the 3F UL Floating Cloud 2, which is a 15D silicon nylon ultralight tent, and it is so light. It's 1.8 with the poles and pegs. So I'm just going to go ahead and get it set up. I have to move this pack. Poles and pegs. Right, put that over there. Okay. Yeah, so we're kind of running out of light here in New Zealand. Sun goes to sets about 5:40 in the afternoon, so I think it's about 4:45 now, so yeah. And plus with all the overcast rain clouds, that makes it appear even darker. So yeah, we're gonna have to use light so you can see everything. Yeah, so these poles just clip together pretty easy. We'll have a better look at it soon, or in the morning when we've got more light, but the real test is tonight. Can it handle being in the rain with sea west? All right. Now it is a little tricky to set up because there's so much tension in the poles. So we need to keep pressure on it at all times. Oh man, I got so wet coming in. Glad I brought a good jacket. Right, here we go. So that's our basic main shape of the tent. And then we just simply clip these over. Four of those on each side. Pretty basic design. I'll just use this side as a door since it's open. And we're gonna have that nearly fully exposed tonight. Move it that way a little bit. We can fully peg it out. All right. Our door. No, we're inside out. We want to go that way. No, that's inside out. It's a bit tricky. Such thin material. There we go. We just have a little tab. Here, that one goes like that. Okay. Oh, I did plan on getting here a bit earlier so that you could all see everything, but it's gone dark super quick. Yeah, it's just got these little tags. They just go under the peg. That sticks out there. Not a very secure adjustment, but seems to do the job. Okay. And make sure we got it lined up correctly. There, right. And under there. All right. Tighten those down. Okay, just gonna get another light going. Pretty standard peg design. Pretty thin and weak, to be honest, but all good for the soft ground we have here. Right. Pick those out. Cool. Excellent. There's leaves and stuff out. I'm actually going to hang this in there. It can go in there like that. Alright. One sleeping bag. One sleeping pad. Well, keep that shut over. I'm so annoyed that my big light's flat. I have to get it on charge as soon as possible. It's a real shame. Get our chair set up. Believe how dark it is early. I like to have at least an hour of light for filming and set up, but I've left it a bit late. Right, that can go. You can go there. You can go here. There we go. Right. So once again, using the Bushbuck Cumulus Light Nature Hike Snowbird 2 degree. So it's quite muggy, so I don't need the minus two. It's overkill. I'll be pumping this up with my Flextail pump, which is what I'm using as a light right now because my main light was dead flat. So my guess is, while it's been in my hiking pack all day, it's been on, which is a shame. But I've got it charging, so we'll see what we can get it charged soon. There. Okay. I'm not going to pump that up just yet. Pump it up later. Just save the battery on the unit for now. All right. It's ready for pumping up, and I've also got my Flextail pillow, which I'll pump up later as well. Okay, the main thing is that's charging. Okay, get this up. I want bugs going in there. All right, everyone. Whew. Right, so everything's set up. Haven't pumped up my bed or anything. We're just having our first shower now. Still waiting for my main light to charge. I'm pretty peed off about that. Ran flat on my pack. Anyway, the Flextail is providing enough light for now. As you can see, it's almost pitch black. I've come in here pretty late, come straight after work with limited light. But that's okay, we can still have a great time, and there's a whole lot of rain scheduled. I think there's about 12 millimeters until the morning. We'll probably see some in the next hour or two through the early a.m., 1, 2, 3 a.m., and then hopefully some around 7 or 8 when we're up and cooking breakfast and stuff like that. Yeah, it's bloody hot, real muggy, but first things first, I got myself a thermocell. If you don't know what a thermocell is, it's an insect repellent device. It runs on butane and it takes a little insect repellent mat. And yeah, that just has a little igniter and it heats up and emits a smoke and there'll be no bugs. And I've already used it on a camp, which I done a few nights ago, which was this test night, to be honest, of this tent, and we didn't get any rain. But I've saved that for another day. For a non-rain camp. Anyway, I'm going to get the thermocell running. So we'll just switch this on. Wait for the little glow. Here we go. There we go, it's heating up. Probably can't see that in there. Probably got about two hours of that repellent mat left before it runs out. So we'll just leave that right there. And let it do its magic. Hopefully it's enough light for everyone to see. I'm going to chill for a little bit. Actually, what I need to do is put my beverage in the stream. I need to go and collect some water as well. So I'll do that now. Right. Hopefully it doesn't run away.
what I like to do is sit it here, some rocks around it. Going. Starting to smoke. All right. Hopefully you can see me. Might be better if I spin my hat. See a bit more of my face, maybe. Oh, right, I got my beer in the stream. It'll be nice and cool. Relatively cool. Cool enough to drink anyway. I won't really care. I'm gonna get dinner, start prepping dinner. So I'm really hungry. And yeah, today I'm using the alcohol stove. Yeah, I brought the whole meth bottle because I don't have much left anyway, so it's nice and light. What have I got for dinner? Got a nice piece of sirloin steak, a scotch fillet. Yeah, sirloin steak, I think, with some onions and some fresh potato salad with bacon aioli in it. So yeah, I'll get onto that in a minute. It's good to just have a wind down for a minute. I've been on my feet moving all day. As you know, I just love chasing the rain. I couldn't miss the opportunity. I could have gone home from work and done stuff all, but I chose to come out in the bush in the rain, get another video done for all yous watching it. And of course, give this new tent a bit of a test. The first test night anyway. I have slept in it. Nice and roomy. It's advertised as a two-person, three-season tent. But I think it's fit for one person, or maybe a couple would fit nicely in there. But yeah, one person with all your gear. It's nice, super lightweight. Probably the lightest tent I have, besides a tarp. So yeah, I'm pretty sure it's going to handle the rain. 3FUL has a pretty good reputation. Chinese manufacturer, Chinese company, but most of my stuff is Chinese and most of it performs well. Yeah, it's fully seam sealed. It's got a bathtub style floor, fully seam sealed. The elderfly is fully seam sealed. Some of the zip areas where they should be aren't seam sealed, so we'll have to see how that performs. And of course, very light material, so it gets caught in the zips constantly, so you have to use two hands constantly untangling it in the zip, which is a bit of a shame, but that seems standard with these cheap tents anyway. Right, I'm going to start prepping the onion, which is in the tent. Onion, and then we'll get our alcohol stove set up. That thermocell is just starting to smoke. There you go. I'm not sure if anyone can see that from there. Yeah, doesn't smell like too much yet, but there's no bugs around me. And there's bugger all wind, so hopefully it sort of floats around rather than getting pushed away. And you might have noticed I haven't guidelined the tent. There's virtually no wind tonight, so we're going to be fine. I've pegged it out though. It's fully pegged out. will be sweet as, and we're sheltered here. Rightio, I'm going to get this onion. Start prepping that. Okay, we're on a bit of a lean here. I think what we'll do is try and even it out. Should have done that before. There. Now we need to try level it somehow, so maybe we will put it there. It can go there. You might be wondering, why have I got a mixing bowl? That is for breakfast. Got something planned that I haven't tried before camping. It's going to be yum. Canadian. Bit of a Canadian twist to it, if that gives you any hint. Don't need that. I am going to make a hot drink later. So we need to go collect some water with my new Katadin. Now, I am going to So my last video was the car camp in the campground, which is only about maybe 2 or 3 kilometres from here. So technically it's the same set of ranges, the Waitakere ranges, which is about, I think, maybe 300 or 400 hectares of native forests and trees and wildlife. That looks pretty level. So just a beautiful area, and I tend to stick to it quite a lot with my camping. Okay. Get our onion, light that, get it heating up, get our steak. Right. There we go. It's going to heat up. Should be relatively level. Bit of paracord. Okay. Right, that's gonna almost be hot enough to get our pan on there now. Quite a bit of onion, it'll shrink down. We don't want those bits. Right. Oh yeah, it's nice and level. The methylated spirits takes a little bit to heat up and get going sometimes. Get in there. It's an efficient way of cooking, and of course I've only got the cheap man's Trangia. Pretty budget one, but works. How many camps have I used it on now? Most of them, I think. Okay, I've got some I've got some rosemary and garlic butter. That's what I'll be cooking the steak with, and everything else. Okay.
How's that? Is that better?
Charged our light up. It's not fully charged, but it'll be charged enough. Hopefully that's a lot better lighting for you for this twilight camping. Well, I arrived pretty late, but who cares? We're out here. Right, I've got a New Zealand beef sirloin steak. Nice and fresh. No need to get an up close of that. So we'll get this on first. Oh, yum. It's going to nice sizzle. Nice, decent bit with a bit of fat on there. There we go. Put that over there out of sight. Now we don't need that. There we go. Don't need the hand lamp anymore. Thermocell is cranking away. Just what we want. No bugs. It's awesome. It is awesome. Might actually put that light on. There. We don't need both bulbs going. And that'll save the battery to a degree as well. Okay. Oh yeah. That garlic butter. Now, let's get some seasoning on there. I just have some mixed herbs, pretty basic. And a bit of salt as well. Nice. There we go. That steak's not going to take long, so I might actually get the onions off to the side there. They can just fry away. Oh, his stomach is growling because it knows there's food. Oh, this is going to be good. Yeah, anyway, what was I saying before? I hope everyone enjoyed the van camp video with the tarp. It's luxury compared to this, having the air mattress and nice warm of the inside of the car. It's autumn here in New Zealand, so we're approaching winter soon. It's going to get a lot colder. I think right now it's about 12 degrees, so it's a little chilly to be in shorts, but it's all right. Okay, I'm ready. Let's flip it. Oh, yum. Nice. I flipped that at the right time, didn't I? Just sit that over so it controls the flame a little bit. We don't need it roaring. Right, let that fry for a bit more. I wish I leveled this table. Right, just got some potato salad here. It's got aioli, potato and bacon.
got it from my local supermarket. All right, woo! Nice big juicy steak. And what else do we have? Onions. Let's get those on. Need to turn this off first. There we go. Cheers, everyone. Check it out, nice bit of sirloin. That's nice and tender. Potato salad and some onions. Yum. Mm-hmm. Very good. Yum. Now, I need to try level this table, I think. It's going to be a nightmare. Let's try a bit of steak. Hmm, perfect. Right, I'm going to move this. Well, that rain didn't last long at all. Just a brief shower. There'll be more later. Possums. Can you see that steaming away? Thermostat is working. No bugs. It is great. Shout out to Mr. Tony AB Camping for using one of those, because if I hadn't seen it, him using it, I wouldn't have one right now. They're a total game changer. I'm going to finish dinner and we'll come back to you soon. I'll be going to get my beer out of the creek, which is another one from Garage Project I haven't tried before. And yeah, we'll just be chilling back, waiting for the showers to come. Okay, just went and got my beer. It's a little bit cooler than it was. So what have we got tonight? This is another Garage Project Brewery's beer. Unconditional Love Mixed IPA. Check out the artwork on this. 7.5% alcohol volume. It's got this little track list thing on the back of it. Quite hard case. 2.6 standard drinks. Yeah, hopefully this kicks my behind, help me have a good sleep. Andy Shaw, artist Andy Shaw. Yeah, very cool can. Anyway, let's open it up. Not fizzed up, it's good. Fruity. Ooh. Oh, here comes some rain. Opening the can is the trick to getting rain, apparently. Oh, that's nice. Cheers, everyone. Thanks for joining me on yet another adventure in the rain. Oh, that's good. Now, another thing I was going to touch on tomorrow is what we call Anzac Day here in New Zealand. Anzac Day is celebrated in New Zealand and Australia, united. It's to commemorate fallen soldiers from World War One and Two between us neighbours, Australia and New Zealand. It also commemorates active servicemen as well, and women, of course. So tomorrow, we're going to wake up to Anzac Day, and I'm going to cheers my drink to my granddad, Eric Keats, who served in the 24th Battalion in World War II, 1939 to 1945. He went to Syria, Egypt. I think a lot of that 24th Battalion was known for its Egypt and Syria invasions, if you would call it that. As far as I'm aware from stories I've heard, he saw a lot of nasty stuff and had to do a lot of nasty stuff, as I imagine many men and women had to do. But unfortunately, he passed away in 1997 when I was about 7 years old, so I would have loved to known him as an adult. We're very much alike. We're both into the same stuff. And so cheers to my granddad, Eric Keats. Oh, that's a nice brew. And of course, cheers to everyone else watching. Appreciate you sticking around and watching my videos. It's getting a little bit chilly. Put my down jacket on. There we go. That's much better, much more cozy. Oh. Yeah. All right, everyone, we have rain. Man, holy hell, we have to move some things. Go under there. That can get a washout, that's all good. Holy hell, that just came out of nowhere. It just went bam. It didn't even start off slowly, it just was out of nowhere, like a shower getting turned on. Oh, we've got some serious...
Wow, got some serious spray coming in. Wow. Can't believe how aggressive that is. Oh. All right, I think we're all right. Far out. Is the thermocell okay? Yeah, it's all right. Might actually turn that off anyway. Now that the rain's here, we're going to jump in bed soon anyway. Wowee. That was like someone turned the tap on. And there is just rain spray in every direction right now. Man. Oh well, this is why we come out here. This is what we're after. We'll do a tent inspection, just in case. I should actually have these closed. Oh no! Just kidding. Everything looks all right. I had you for a second. I might actually just close this one out. And what we'll do is we'll peg. Oh, should I do that? No. Yeah, we'll do this side. We'll peg that out. So where are our pegs going? Under here somewhere. Yeah. That way, if the rain does run down, it has somewhere to run off. Peek that out like that. I'm still in shock with how fast that rain hit. We don't need that anymore. We can go there for now. That has to stand up. Yeah, it can get washed out by the rain. Set that over there. Man. Crazy. Crazy, crazy, crazy. This one Tigris tarp has been... How many camps have I taken that on? First camp was the one I had to bail out. which was early December. So I've probably taken this tarp on 5 or 6 trips now. Yeah, 5 or 6 trips. I haven't actually washed it. All I've done when it's been wet and I've got back from a camp, is I've hung it out on the deck or in the washing line, and it air dries within 30-40 minutes. It's air dry. Roll it up, pack it away. Sometimes I will use a bit of a sponge to soak up any moisture, but it's been a really great tarp. It hasn't got the best tie-off points. They could have done some bigger hoops, but you know, it's actually a hammock fly, believe it or not. 3x4, I think it is. Yeah, 3x4. It's almost overkill for a camp like this, but I've got over half of this tent is exposed to the rain. It's sort of at the top of the pitch here, so for anyone that thinks that I've got the tent covered completely by a tarp, I haven't. I have it exposed on purpose, just so we can give the tent a proper test. And another thing, the tarp actually induces the water to run off onto the top of the tent with a bit of pressure. So if it was going to leak, that's going to help encourage finding a spot where it's going to enter. My guess, if this was to leak, would be around the zip or this collar flap area, if you can see that. Yeah. But it might not. It might not. When I hop into bed, what I'll do is I will peg out this corner and fully zip it down, because some of the rain in the night is meant to get quite heavy. So yeah, that way I've got an area inside to put my boots, keep them outside. Whereas with the other one, Tigress Scania tent that I had here, just such a weird design, it didn't have any vestibule. I'm not finished with that one Tigress tent. I need to take it for more testing. One more test night in heavy rain. I've got some bugs turning up. I didn't think we would. Might as well get the most out of that insect mat. I think it's just about run out. Okay. Let that burn out. Yeah. Pretty persistent rain now. It's going to be nice to listen to in the tent. Speaking of the tent, I'm going to hop in bed. Pretty exhausted. We had a great dinner. Nice beverage. Thank you very much, Garage Project. And tomorrow is another day. Anzac Day, of course. We've got the French toast in the morning. And hopefully a bit of rain. That would be great. Alright. With that said, everyone, I'll see you in the morning. If anything crazy happens later, any real heavy rain, I'll come out and try to capture some of it. Otherwise, we will see you bright and early in the morning. First light.
about 6:30, 6:45 a.m. Yeah. Gonna be a nice day tomorrow. Right. Cheers everyone. See you in the morning.
What a night. Well, I had a pretty good sleep. I think it rained most of the night. Hear that stream, it's a lot louder than it was, and the tarp is a mess from all the leaves and stuff that have dropped down in the rain. And it appears that our 3FUL tent did not leak, at least in the bathtub floor area, from what I've had a look at. We'll go over the rest of the tent soon when we get a bit more light. That sun's popping over right now. Put that back in soon. Right, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to go collect some fresh rainwater from the stream with my Caterton filter bottle. I'm going to do a quick boil up and have a coffee, start the morning. Thank you, Gala, for getting me this. My beautiful partner, the missus. She got me this bottle. It's a 1 litre Caterton fee-free. Yeah, it's got the filter built in, so you can literally filter 99% of bacteria and germs, which means that I can safely drink from streams and creeks. They're pretty clean anyway. But yeah, best to be safe. I'll go get some water.
It's beginning to rain again slightly.
1 litre of stream water here. So I'm going to set up the cooker. Which was... just go and angle a little bit so it's nice and level. The first time I've properly used the Ketterdam bottle, to be quite honest. Let's do it in for a French test. We want to be conservative with our alcohol fuel.
Okay. That'll do. That will do. Actually, what we'll do is we'll put this in first. So I've just got myself a Nescafe flat white sachet, and I only use like a quarter of it, a little bit more. I don't use too much. Okay, this can go off. There we go, perfect amount of water. Using my fork as a spoon. Let that cool down. Set that right there. Okay, so I'm going to have my hot drink. Just going to have a rest for half an hour or so. And yeah, we'll get on with breakfast. French toast with maple syrup. And I think I forgot the icing sugar, which just adds a little special touch to it, so that's a shame. But it's gonna be yum.
warms the soul. We have a duck, a visitor. Where have you come from? Where did you come from? Come over here. Just came out of nowhere. It just appeared. It's right by the tripod. Come here. Hi. Up here. Look. What have I got? What have I got? Here. Yeah. See if we can get him on camera. Alright, we need, didn't bring normal butter. I don't know if I should be using garlic butter. Not the French toast. I think I'll just fry the eggs. Hey buddy, what are you doing? You hanging around? Okay, what we need is some wipes. Our eggs and our bread. We're ready to go.
Hey, you're hanging around.
Got some sourdough bread here. It's just pre-sliced, nice and fresh. Set that there. And those to clean my pan out from last night's steak. And we have our eggs. So what I'm going to do is we'll crack our eggs in here now. Hey buddy. He's hanging around for the French toast. Guarantee you. What are you doing? You hear me say French toast. See us camping in the friendly duck. Put a bit of salt and pepper in here as well. Go there. Hi. Can we move that? Alright. Get some bread in here to soak. Can only split one piece at a time because it's only a small pot. Bowl. What I need to do now is get this going. A little bit of a messy job. There. Get it nice and hot.
go. Let's get the first bit in. There. I think we'll just do three pieces. Because this other bit can go to Mr. Duck.
Mr. Duck, keep him entertained. We have another little bit of bread.
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah. Okay, you can see him in the background. You can look around over there. Alright, French toast. Give this up on the plate. Look at that. Okay, put that there. And what I have here is some Old Canada 100% pure maple syrup.
So if you're from Canada, confirm that this is a good brand. It says it's made in Canada, a Canadian product.
Dollop of this over each bit of French toast. I need to have enough of this stuff. I prefer maple syrup over honey, actually. Well, I don't know, maybe I don't. Alright everyone, cheers, check it out.
French toast in the bush with Sea West camping. Oh, my maple syrup is dripping off.
Mr. Duck has got his bread over there. Piece there, so let's break a bit off. Soak it up with the maple syrup. Oh, that is really good. That is really good. I thought it was going to be a lot tougher and burnt with no butter, but... So good. Mr. Duck over there is getting a good feed. Sourdough bread. Let's see what he thinks of a bit of French toast. Breakfast French toast. That came out really good. Next time I'll bring butter and some icing sugar. Maybe some sliced bananas or something. Something new. For camping anyway, it's the first French toast meal I've ever done for a camp breakfast. There's a stream that it tastes like. Looks really clean. Pretty good, knowing that the wood is being filtered of any harmful stuff. I mean, end of the day, I'm probably only going to get severe stomach cramps or diarrhea, but we don't want that. I'm on the bush. So yeah, picked up my cooking gear. I'm going to pack my sleeping stuff up now. Yeah, just take it easy for another hour and then we will pack up and get out of here. I'm going to visit my mum and we're going to go visit my Nana and Pop's grave and leave some red poppies. After all, it is Anzac Day. If you don't know what Anzac Day is, it's when we commemorate. It's a unity between Australia and New Zealand, and it's to commemorate fallen soldiers during World Wars, World War 1 and 2, and it also commemorates active servicemen and women as well. So yeah, we'll go lay some red poppies, and yeah. I always stuff my down bag, and when I get home, I hang it over a rail in the wardrobe. That way, the loft inside doesn't compress for too long, and it can just store like that. It's actually a really good bag. Definitely didn't need a 2-degree bag last night. The -2 just gets so stuffy, but in about 3 or 4 weeks time these bags will be much more suited to the temperatures as winter approaches. Push all the air out of the down. say a big thank you to Nature Hike. If you're watching, Andy, I really appreciate the effort you put in to outdoor gear, budget outdoor gear. I mean, I'll be honest, not all of it is super good, but money for value, and these sleeping bags are great. Thank you very much for sponsoring my camping adventures with the gear you've given me. Really appreciate it. And hello to your family and everyone over there in Shenzhen, China. Right, that's it done.
It's got a nice waterproof one. See, it's really water dripping. Very thin material, hence why it's so lightweight.
I'd like to remind everyone, I've made a new Instagram for the camping, so go and search on Instagram, SeaWest Camping, SeaWest underscore camping. Yeah, I think it's just SeaWest underscore camping. So go and give me a follow, I'd appreciate that. You see some behind the scenes footage on my stories, things I've been up to. Post lots of pictures on there, so I'd like to grow that up to my first goal's 500. I think we're at about 60 at the moment. So if you're on Instagram, go give me a follow, stay up to date behind the scenes, little trips like this before I release a video. I'd really appreciate it. Looks like the rain's passed now. It's a little bit overcast, but there's a bit of blue sky out there now. But it's been a great night, a lot of rain. It got really heavy while I was in the tent. I think I did a bit of filming, maybe around 3 a.m, 5 a.m. It was crazy. But yeah, good tent, 3FUL, floating fell too. Stood up to the heavy rain, and it's more than half exposed, so it's not under attack. Part of the front is, but yeah, the back of it's fully exposed. It got a hammering. So for anyone that comments, it's not going to leak because it's under a tarp. It was more than half exposed, so there you go. All right, I'm going to get the tent packed up. I'm going to get the tent packed up now, shake it off, I'm going to look at the inside, but I'm not going to see too much. Just want to check out some of the seam sealing I couldn't see up the top ridge, and yeah, we'll pack that away, and then we'll pull our tarp down and that'll be us. Be hiking on out of here. an interesting design how the buckles go underneath the holes, but seems to work okay if you can show that up. Now, the thing you'll notice with this tent is it's nylon all the way up to the top, and it has a mesh roof, so that's a pretty cool feature. Most of them are mesh the whole way. It's saturated. Yeah, so it's got the mesh roof up here, and the rest is all the nylon. Most of them, everything's mesh from about here up. Yeah. It's a half attempt at a full season design, I guess. Nice easy setup and packaging. I'm not too sure on the retail price of this. I will add it in the description when I edit the video. My guess is probably around the $200 mark, maybe a bit cheaper. I'll add that in the description and the link to the tent, as well as a discount code if you're interested in this tent. These poles have a lot of pressure on them when you lift it up. Okay, we'll get this pole. We'll be upgrading the pegs of this tent to some larger diameter. They're just too small. They've bent far too easily. But, in this case, the original ones that came with the pump. So it's fully seam sealed. Very thin material. Concerned how strong it is. If it's a ripstop nylon or not. I didn't use guide lines last night due to it just being no wind, and we didn't need them. If the forecast was wind, of course I would have set them up, but we didn't need them. I try not to use them where I can because they can be a pain, especially when I'm getting up and walking around and filming. So small.
the diameter of it.
It's got an interesting bag. It's not like your typical tent bag. It's kind of like a Hilleberg bag.
Right, that leaves the tarp and the chair. Drink for a second.
Hot work. But it's good, we enjoy it, don't we? Gotta put the effort in to make these videos. See something I'm using, go check out my description on each video. I'll just have to scroll down for the gear list. Everything should be there. I'll try and update it with the new items. For example, this Nature Hike chair and table is on there. I don't do any affiliate links though, so you'll have to find it yourself, but everything can be found online. Wherever you are in the world. I've had this table and chair for about nearly 2 years now.
Right, let's take this tarp down.
this track. Very consistent rain.
One more. I'm not harming any of these trees. I'm doing a taut line hitch, which is just a very basic hitch knot around the trees, and I'm not damaging them. There's not much pressure on them at all.
Jibber jam around. Get out of here. Oh, substantially lighter. I think we're around 13, 14 kilos today, so nice weight.
Everyone, we are out of here. We've got about 3 river crossings to do. It doesn't look like the water has lifted too much overnight, despite the amount of rain we've had. Alright. Okay, it was a really good night. Loads of rain, testing a new tent, some yummy food, and a new beverage to try. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Helps the video a lot. Leave a comment below. Happy to answer any questions. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button, which will be down on the right hand side of me somewhere here. Try and build our subscriber base up. My next goal is 20k, so you helping me getting there, really appreciate it. I've got a river to cross here, well, a stream. Not very high at all. Cheers everyone, see you on the next one.